Hello friends, welcome. Today I'm going to make a video about the true kingdom of God within us. I've spoken about this before, but I've never really spoken just about this. So, the true kingdom of God's not outside of us, it's what we are within us, a spiritual being. So let's take, for example, this world. Now, we're born as infants, babies, and we can't do anything much other than depend on our mother or father to feed us, can we? So, we slowly age and get older, and we begin to learn new skills, don't we? How to, you know, say words, the first basic ones, and crawl and move about, and eventually stand up and walk, and then start eating our own dinner with a knife and fork, and however we eat it, and you know, many skills we learn. And this is actually evolution, isn't it? You know, evolving into a fully grown adult human being and finding the skills and abilities and intelligence to do that through experience and learning. So we can become equals to our own mother and father, can't we? The same level of them. We have our own personal identity. We're not them, but are likened to them and are likened to all other adults in the world. And we continue to learn, even once we're adults, don't we? Throughout our whole lifetime here, until the day we die, we could still learn something new each day. So really, evolution and spiritual evolution is about looking for a lesson in every day. So there is a lesson in every day if you look for it, a new experience to learn from. Maybe a mistake you made, maybe some new piece of information you've learned, or a better way to do something. It could be all kinds of things. Now, I speak about the true kingdom of God being within us, not without of us. Now, God has created this physical plane, and it kind of pulls the wool over our eyes a bit about what we truly are, because we think we're physical. But there is no life without spirit. So when our mother and father procreate us, Father God gives us the divine spark of life, our own personal spirit, which he took a small part of spirit from himself in the beginning, one part, and he blessed it to divide and subdivide and keep dividing and subdividing all life. Everywhere, even on the other worlds of God, all comes from that first spark of life, a division of it, so identical to that first spark. And that is the spirit of God within you. So it is the same thing, really, that what the real kingdom of God is not the physical world or the spiritual planes we live on, which are more or less like physical worlds. It's a place to live. It's a place to enjoy. It's a place to do things and, you know, to be constructive, and where we can have, you know, relations with others and such, for so on and such forth. So the physical planes have a purpose, yes, but they're just somewhere to live. They are not the kingdom of God, because many believe we go up into the spirit realm, it's some perfect place, and because it's a perfect place to be, a perfect world, and it's not, you know. But the higher a plane you achieve, and there are 12 planes in all, 10 are achieved by man, and you know, this is plane one, and man has achieved plane 10, and God lives on plane 12. What's on plane 11 and 12? We don't know, other than we know God's on plane 12. And that, you know, Christ and Citadel is the brother of Christ, lived on plane 10 because they want to be with other people. They're probably the two most evolved spirit on that plane. But there are many evolved spirit on that plane. That's evolution. So life is really about spiritual continual evolution and physical while we're here. So you can go to the next plane. It's not so different from this world, because the people still got all the same attitudes. And yes, they have hate there, they have despise there, they have negativity there. But the higher the plane you evolve to, the less that happens, of course, until, you know, two or three planes above that is perfect harmony, you know. But still you can keep evolving. So the true kingdom of God is what you are as a spiritual being, and unraveling and discovering and evolving what you are as a spiritual being is evolution. And that's what is in within you to seek and discover and to find, isn't it? So that is the true kingdom, what you can become, what more you are, what you can discover, what you truly are, a spiritual being that has many, many abilities. Now, I've said about our parents here, we can evolve to the same level as what they are, can't we? Or approximately. So Father God gives us his spirit, divine spirit. He puts no limitations upon it. So potentially you are an unlimited being and you can evolve and continue to evolve until you get to the level of God, a God or goddess yourself. Because Father God does not put any limitations upon us, like our own parents down here. We can grow through evolution and spiritual self-discovery to the level of God. So that is possible. It would take an infinite time to do, because, you know, that's a lot to evolve to, becoming a like unto God, isn't it? But he doesn't put no limitations upon us. He's a loving father. He doesn't say, well, I'm God and nobody else can be, but I want my own children, but they're not allowed to be as good as me. No, of course not. He doesn't do that at all. What he does is put a certain way of us becoming that, so that we are appropriate and learn the right lessons through the different planes of evolution and so on and so forth, that we become appropriate to have such abilities and powers. Now, the God powers come from the chakra. Almost certainly, I believe, that God power is his spiritual chakra, and that you have chakra too. The same chakra, basically, as what God's got. Only the fact is, yours are turned down very low. Not God turned him down low, it's just you started from a very basic beginning, and as you become more spiritually evolved, your chakras increase and increase and increase and increase in power. And those beings on plane 10 are very much more spiritually progressed and more powerful spiritually than what we are here, or the next plane, or any plane in between. So that is self-discovery. That is the true kingdom of God, what you can find within yourself, isn't it? To develop and bring out and discover who you really are, a spiritual being and a part of God. And, you know, you've got that God spirit within you, and you've got to unravel it and find it and discover what it truly is. And you can evolve great abilities and continue to do so till you become a god or a goddess yourself, most likely. Now, you don't have to choose to do that. You can stay on any plane you wish to and cease to evolve. You don't have to. It's free will, isn't it? It's for those that want to. So it is about casting off our negativities and about beginning here on this earth plane to do that, not just in the spirit realm. If you want to evolve, and there are some on this plane that are very evolved for this plane spiritually, very loving, very peaceful, very forgiving, very merciful, many different things, generous of spirit, helpful to others, some, and spiritually progressed maybe in different ways, that they actually go to plane 3. They skip the next plane because they're evolved enough to go to plane 3. That's the odd person. Most of us go to plane 2. So we have to learn to get rid of the negative attributes, because we both have light and dark within us, and better ourselves. And, you know, that's self-discovery, isn't it? Because our spirit is a spirit of God and a shining light within us, which produces the aura, the chakras, and so on and so forth. And it can continue to increase. Let your light shine before you, they say, don't they? So you can become ever more increasingly evolved by personal choice. And here is the place to start doing it, by self-realization. So it's true, isn't it? It's what you can become, not the place that you live on. And of course, as you evolve, you still have material possessions, because every spirit plane beyond this, and this is considered part of the spirit realm, plane 1. Every plane beyond this is at a higher state of vibration, but still has all the same things, physical semblance, because it's in a much higher vibration like spirit are. So they can still make cars and all the rest of it they want to make. And even on the very highest plane, plane 10, they still have physical properties in an etheric state. So they make use of them. But, you know, you cast off greed and physical things, but some physical things are useful to have, aren't they? Like clothes to wear or a piece of equipment you need to do your job. So, you know, that's the way it is, isn't it? Anyway, I just wanted to explain that, you know, our parents always want us to, usually, if they care for us, become as good as they are, if not surpass us. And of course, Father God cannot be surpassed, but he too would like to see his children go on that pathway of evolution through the spirit realms on all the different planes and discover who they are and who they want to be and what their latent spiritual abilities are, which we can bring out and become ever increasingly more capable and powerful and self-aware. And, ultimately you can find the higher self in time. You see little insights of it to begin with, or have little experiences of it. Eventually, you could become the higher self itself all the time. So it is capable of virtually anything. Anyway, love and light to you. Hope you enjoyed that. Neil.